हेलो एवरीवन, आप सभी का फिर से एक बार स्वागत है मेरे यूट्यूब चैनल में जिसका नाम है कॉमर्स ट्रेजर। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सम मोर एमसीक्यूज़ ऑन फाइनेंशियल मैनेजमेंट। इफ़ यू हैव नॉट सीन द फर्स्ट टू वीडियोज़ ऑन फाइनेंशियल मैनेजमेंट, आई हैव गिवन द लिंक इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन एंड इन द आई बटन अबो। सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग मच टाइम, लेट्स स्टार्ट द एमसीक्यूज़। सो द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज डिविडेंड पे आउट रेशियो, विच वी ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज डीपी रेशियो, इज कंप्यूटेड बाय PAT डिवाइडेड बाई कैपिटल, DPS डिवाइड बाई EPS, प्रिफरेंस डिविडेंड डिवाइड बाई PAT, प्रिफरेंस डिविडेंड डिवाइड बाई इक्विटी डिविडेंड। सो द राइट आंसर इज DPS डिवाइडेड बाई EPS, दैट इज डिविडेंड पर शेयर डिवाइडेड बाई EPS, दैट इज अर्निंग पर शेयर, यू विल गेट द DP रेशियो। द सेकेंड क्वेश्चन इज विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग कॉस्ट रिक्वायर्स टैक्स एडजस्टमेंट। नाउ दिस क्वेश्चन हैज बीन रिपीटेड 2-3 times, सो जस्ट रिमेंबर वेन एवर यू गेट दिस ऑप्शन ऑफ टैक्स, यू हैव टू रिमेंबर टैक्स इज यूजुअली गिवन ओनली इन कॉस्ट ऑफ डिबेंचर्स, दैट इज KD और KI। सो ऑलवेज टैक्स बेनिफिट्स वी आर गोइंग टू गेट इन योर कॉस्ट ऑफ डिबेंचर्स। द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज एट इनडिफरेंस लेवल ऑफ EBIT डिफरेंट कैपिटल्स विल हैव। सो इनडिफरेंस पॉइंट इज अ पॉइंट वेयर देर विल बी डिफरेंट कैपिटल्स बट दे आर गोइंग टू हैव द सेम EPS, दैट इज सेम अर्निंग पर शेयर। द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज इन ऑर्डर टू फाइंड आउट कॉस्ट ऑफ इक्विटी, दैट इज KE, कैपिटल अंडर CAPM मॉडल, दैट इज कैपिटल असेट प्राइजिंग मॉडल, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड। सो आउट ऑफ 4, 3 आर रिक्वायर्ड एंड 1 इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड। सो वॉट इज द फॉर्मूला फॉर KE अंडर CAPM मॉडल? सो द फॉर्मूला इज KE इज इक्वल टू RF प्लस RM माइनस RF इंटू बीटा, वेर RF इज रिस्क फ्री रेट ऑफ रिटर्न, सो डेफिनेटली वी रिक्वायर रिस्क फ्री रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट। RM is market rate of return, that is the return which we are expecting in the market, and B is equal to beta factor, that is the risk associated with that particular market. So all these three are required. Market price of equity share is not required in case of CAPM model of KE. Practical questions are also asked on this topic where they will give you RF, they will give you RM, and they will give you beta, and you have to compute using the formula RF plus RM minus RF into beta to find out the cost of equity. The next question is cost of issuing new shares to the public is known as. Cost of equity is not the answer because cost of equity is the cost of equity share capital. Cost of capital is nothing but the rate of return which is expected by the investors. Marginal cost of capital is also not the answer because it is a cost of additional funds. So whenever you are issuing new shares, whatever cost is incurred, we call it as flotation cost, and it is denoted by small f. The next question is cost of equity share capital, that is KE, is more than cost of debt, that is KD, because of the following reason. So why is always KE greater than KD? Because the answer is equity shares have higher risk than debt. So as the risk is higher, more return is expected. So this is a basic rule which we remember in your security market, that is as the risk goes on increasing, the return expected by the investors also goes on increasing. So the right answer is going to be equity share have higher risk, therefore they expect higher return, and therefore the cost of capital is more. The next question is which of the following is not a generally accepted approach for calculation of cost of equity. So there are different methods for cost of equity. Among these four options, one is not the method of computation of cost of equity. CAPM model definitely is an method which we saw, that is RF plus RM minus RF into beta. Dividend discount model, this is also a method where KE is equal to dividend divided by P0, that is the market price of the share. Earnings yield method, that is also a method for computation of KE. So as per this method, KE is equal to EPS divided by MPS. EPS is earning per share and MPS is nothing but the market price. So CAPM, dividend discount model, and earnings yield method, all three are methods, but this rate of preference dividend plus risk is not a method. Instead of this, there is one more method which is called as growth method, which is also used, wherein the formula becomes KE is equal to D1 divided by P0 plus the growth rate. The next question is which of the following is a liability of a bank. Now treasury bills are the bills which are issued by the government and which are purchased by either the banks or the wealthy persons or the cash rich companies. कमर्शियल पेपर्स आर अगेन द सिक्योरिटीज विच आर इशूड बाई द कंपनीज एंड विच आर यूजली परचेज बाई द बैंक्स. CDs, दैट इज सर्टिफिकेट ऑफ डिपोजिट्स, आर द शॉर्ट टर्म सिक्योरिटीज विच आर परचेज बाई द कैश रिच कंपनीज, दैट इज कंपनी विच हैव एक्सेस कैश एंड दे आर इशूड बाई द बैंक्स. सो यूजली हाउ यू कैन रिमेंबर द डिफरेंस बिटवीन CPs एंड CDs, कमर्शियल पेपर्स आर इशूड बाई द कंपनीज and bank as it accepts deposit, it also accepts certificate of deposit. So bank is going to issue CDs and it will be purchased by companies, whereas CPs is the reverse. In CP, bank is going to purchase and companies are going to issue. So hope these differences are clear to you. These are also the important types of short-term finances which are asked in your exams. The next question is, one of the difference between operating lease and financial lease is? Now, operating lease and financial lease, there are so many differences which can be asked in an exam. What you can remember, in case of operating lease, the ownership is always with the lessor, and in case of financial lease, the ownership will be transferred at the end to the lessee. In case of operating lease, all the risk as well as rewards will be given to the lessor, and in case of financial lease, all the risk as well as the rewards are going to be with the lessee. And one major important difference which you have to remember is, in case of operating lease, the lease contract is cancelable by the lessee, but financial lease, it is not possible. So the right difference between operating lease and financial lease among this option is, operating lease is generally cancelable, but financial lease cannot be cancelled. The next question is, basic objective of diversification. Now, diversification is nothing but when you split your securities into different types of securities or different sources of securities, then it is called as diversification. So diversification basic objective is to decrease the risk, right friends? So we call it as minimization of risk or decreasing the risk. The next question is, if the intrinsic value of a share is less than the market price, which of the following is most reasonable? Now, what is an intrinsic value? Intrinsic value is the value which you as an investor estimate for a security, and market price is a price which they are being sold in the market. So they are asking you, if the intrinsic value is less than the market price, then what is going to happen? We'll just take a simple example to understand this question. So think that the intrinsic price or intrinsic value is rupees 10 and the market price is rupees 15. So now just see, intrinsic value is less than the market price. So in this case, what happens is, you think that the stock is overpriced, right? So the right answer is going to be, the market is overvaluing the stock, because as per you, it is rupees 10, but in the market, it is selling for more. If it was a reverse case, then you would have said that the market is undervaluing the share. So such type of share in the example, you should not purchase, because you are going to pay more than it's worth, then it is not a useful stock. The next question is, cost of capital for government securities is known as. So government securities usually are risk-free securities, so we call it as risk-free rate of interest, where risk is equal to zero and returns are also less compared to the other riskier securities. The next question is, in case the firm is all equity finance, that is 100% if there is equity capital in the firm, then WACC, that is weighted average cost of capital, or KO, or overall cost of capital, will be equal to the cost of equity. If it is 100% debt based company, then it is going to be equal to KD, that is cost of debt. And if it is finance in a proportion which includes both debt and equity, then we call it as WACC, that is weighted average cost of capital based on the weights of both the sources. The next question is, which of the following source of funds has an implicit cost of capital? Now, implicit cost is nothing but cost of the opportunity which you have foregone. So this means that there are some capital which you could have invested somewhere else and you could have got more returns. In the given four options, रिटेन्ड अर्निंग्स इज सोर्स ऑफ कैपिटल विच हैज इम्प्लिसिट कॉस्ट ऑफ कैपिटल. इट मीन्स दैट रिटेन्ड अर्निंग्स इफ यू हैव नॉट केप्ट इन द कंपनी यू कुड हैव इन्वेस्टेड इट समवेयर एल्स एंड यू माइट हैड गॉट एक्स्ट्रा रिटर्न फॉर दिस रिटेन्ड अर्निंग्स. द लास्ट क्वेश्चन फॉर द वीडियो इज विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग हैज द हाइएस्ट कॉस्ट ऑफ कैपिटल. सो एज वी डिस्कस्ड अर्लियर इन द प्रीवियस क्वेश्चन दैट इक्विटी शेयर has the highest cost of capital because the risk associated with equity share capital is more compared to the preference share capital which comes after equity share, bonds which comes after preference shares, that is the KD, and loans, it depends upon the rate which banks charges. So above equity share there is one more source which is called as derivatives, which is even more higher in terms of security market risk. So cost of capital, if you have to say, equity share capital has the highest cost of capital in the given options. So that's all for today. If you like the video, please hit the like button. And if you haven't subscribed my channel yet, please subscribe my channel and share it with your friends so that I can come up with more of such videos. Thank you guys for your support and meet you again in the next video.